Speaking of Elijah Holyfield, you'll hear his name a lot tonight, at least in the pregame show. But I had a chance to sit down with him earlier this week and get to know him as a student and as a son, and what it was like, I mean, to grow up with the last name Holyfield. Check it out.
Holyfield looking to air it out. Holyfield going low, and he's taking a shot. He's going for it.
Evander Holyfield is the only five-time heavyweight champion of the world, and his son, Elijah, is writing his own success story. A senior at Woodward, he's the fifth best running back in the country, and he's committed to the University of Georgia.
You know, I grew up a Georgia fan, grew up watching Georgia all my life, and, you know, I never thought about, you know, actually playing for him, and then once the opportunity came, it kind of was like always like, I don't know how I'm going to say no.
And being the son of a high-profile athlete, Elijah was never far away from sports.
Even before he was old enough to be able to actually run, his dad had him out there on the track field.
The point of the matter is just wanting him to realize that you had to be the very best you could be. You don't need to be doing everything somebody else do. You got to understand what worked for you.
But growing up with the last name Holyfield in no way gave Elijah the green light to cut corners.
Did people ever treat you differently on the football field or in school because you had a successful father?
You know, you could hear parents in the stands and stuff like that, but as I got older, the players, you know, they kind of feel a certain way about me too. You know, some people treat you better, some people act like you got something over them or something like that, and act like you did something wrong for who my dad is. But, you know, I try my best just to, you know, stay even keel.
But the player he's become is more of a testament to the work ethic instilled in him and less about anything being handed to him. In fact, as parents, their proudest moments have nothing to do with football.
You know, the football stuff is something that he loves to do, but, you know, with me, it's the academic side of it. Elijah made the honor roll. He's actually made it every year at Woodward, so I've been very proud of him, and that's always a highlight in my life.
The greatest thing for me is our relationship going to church. I want him to know that. Because this is how I made it, regardless to whatever everybody think.
For Evander Holyfield, his biggest cheerleader was always his mother. And for Elijah, he's never been without an extremely deep support system.
Oh, I'm proud of Elijah. He's always worked hard. No matter what he does, he applies himself 100%, you know, on and off the field.
My proudest moment is when people come up and tell me, they say, oh, he outworked everybody. I'm saying that, so that's kind of like, this is what life is about.
When you see, you know, your dad at the games or in your mom, and how does that make you feel?
I know no matter what, I'm gonna have a great support system. You know, it's my mom, my grandma, my auntie. So it's something I never had to worry about as growing up, is somebody not being there to watch me, because they've always been there.
I also asked him if, you know, when he's ready to take that big hit, is he nervous? Is he ready? And he kind of rolled his eyes like, no. He said that gets him in the zone faster. He's ready to take that big hit, but who knew it would come as soon as tonight.
You know, I covered his dad, Evander, for the bite fight against Mike Tyson in Las Vegas back in 1996. And, you know, Evander wasn't the biggest heavyweight. He wasn't the strongest heavyweight. He wasn't the quickest heavyweight. But he had the biggest heart,
right.
And he has passed that on to his son.